For a limited time, get the VHS box set.
CBS News.
Can't you smell it?
Brand new victim of shatter those dreams, the culture.
Hi there, it's been a bit, so I guess it's time to... Here, I got some notes. I wasn't really prepared for this. Now that I'm ready for you, welcome to this new series I'm calling The Catch-Up. Where I'll be, in this series, I'll be reviewing movies that I've seen, but I just haven't reviewed yet.
So you never know what movie's gonna pop up next.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog, to cry all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. Well, you ain't nothing but a rabbit, and you ain't no friend of mine.
You ain't nothing but a
dog, player, I get it. Frog, player, I get it.
Ladies and gentlemen, reporting from the Elvis Presley fan club is none other than Mr. That's his actual name. That's his legit name. Okay. It's Mr. Melvis Wesley.
Thank you very much, Chuck. Please stop applauding. Seriously. I'm trying to be humble up here.
Yes, my name is Melvis Wesley. I was originally Melvin Wesley before changing my name to, you know, I was inspired by the great king of rock and roll. Now, some of you might not realize this, but I am actually an Elvis impersonator, so I'll try to keep it up for you. Try to keep the veil there, anyway. So I'll try to keep the voice, but who knows when it's going to fall out. I'm just going to be a little country bumpkin. Have you guys heard of this little movie that came out? Buzz Lerman's Elvis?
Yeah!
Well, yeah, in this new movie, you end up living the whole life of Elvis Presley. The king of rock and roll himself. But it's through the narration of, you would never believe it. You would never believe who they got up here. They've got Tom Hanks as Tom Parker. I know. It's shocking. Shocking they'll do this to us Elvis fans. We know Tom Parker is full of crap.
Yes!
We know that. He killed Elvis. He killed Elvis. This movie confirms it!
Yes!
He tries to
say, man, you got this.
He tries to stick up for himself. But we know.
Yes.
We know what he did.
Yes.
All this yelling's got me a little thirsty. Oh. Sorry about that, tech crew. I'm really sorry.
You have got to be kidding.
Anyway, dude, you end up living through this whole guy's life. I felt like I was Elvis Presley. Going through it, I was Melvis Wesley. I was Elvis Presley. Let me tell you, you go through this whole movie, the pace is so fast. Oh, just from scene to scene, just melds together. The editing, the smooth transitions from scene to scene, there's no time to talk. We're going fast paced. We're going, every second is another part of his career. We're going through his life. I mean, now I know exactly what the king went through. I went through all of it. One of the fastest paced movies of the year for sure. I'm not even mentioning that's 3 hours long. It's still super fast. You just fly through. Sometimes you feel the 3 hours, which could be a problem, but you're like going through this whole guy's life. You're invested, man. You're invested. It's visually appealing as it marries visuals and performance and music together. in a beautiful friendship. As the reds and yellows of fame pop before your eyes, just like Elvis Presley experiencing the downfalls of fame. The downfalls of fame! Fame killed Elvis Presley as well, not just his manager, Tom Parker. Don't you forget it. Don't you forget it. Solve it. Solve it, please. Don't you forget it. Calm down, Solve it. Calm down, calm down. We're in a professional atmosphere. I mean, just the visual angles, the atmosphere this movie creates is just so enticing. You're like living every little bit and part of Elvis's life. And Elvis's life is like split off in so many atmospheres, so many different environments, and the colors coordinate with it. That's good filmmaking. I don't know much about films. I only watch old Elvis music performances and music videos, but forget about that. Just listen to my words. Jeez, is it hot up here, or am I on fire?
Oh, yeah.
I'm on fire.
You are on fire, Elvis. You should be the next top review.
Yes, Sullivan. Yeah. Thanks, Sullivan. Thank you, Sullivan.
You're the best, Elvis. You and I both know it.
And just like how the camera captures every single segment of Elvis's life in every era, so does the wardrobe. Oh, yeah. The wardrobe is fantastic. It's beautiful. Every single outfit Elvis wears, every single outfit everybody wears. His wife, his children, his child. I forgot for a second that there was only one child. No, I am a true Elvis fan. Stop. I'm a true Elvis fan. But again, the wardrobe is fantastic. Every outfit matches and popping in color with the atmosphere that it's taking place in and where they're performing. The soundtrack is also really, really good, very phenomenal. They added some hip-hop tracks, which I guess will help get the youths into the booths, but it threw me off. It kind of lost a little bit of its artistic integrity in capturing the time. But despite this, each song is used to capture the mood of the moment. Even the hip-hop parts really captures the atmosphere and bounces along with it. I still dock some points for having random songs in this movie, but hey, it's what it had to be, so I'm fine with it. Austin Butler does a killer performance as the king himself. He gets all the mannerisms down, the voice down, better than me. He ends up just capturing this character, not character, this king, this reality that once lived in the 60s, 70s, and then died off sadly.
But, crazy Elvis.
He does an incredible job. He captures that rise to fame, that lust for fame, and then getting his wings clipped. And it's just he sells that sad story. He was doing pretty good throughout the movie. But then, near the end, there's a scene with him and Tom Hanks that just sold both characters for me. And they both did an incredible job. It was almost an Oscar-winning performance by both of them near the end, where these two characters come to a head. And it just upgraded the performances for me. It was incredible to see. It was incredible to witness. Tom Hanks is very cartoonish at first. I thought he would be a very cartoonish character. But he ended up following through. He didn't sell the manager as a blood-sucking person. He ends up being like that, but that's part of his fatal flaw. He actually sells that struggle with doing the right thing and then doing it for selfish gain. And of course, we know what he ends up choosing in the end, but it's still that moment when it all collides and both of them are putting on these killer performances. That sold the performances for me. Some of the best performances of the year. Other performances I thought were pretty good was Dacre Montgomery as producer Steve Binder. He had a small role, but he did such a good job with that small role. And I mean, he's upgraded from being a killer bully on Stranger Things, so anything's better than that. Murdering people, yeah, getting monsters involved and all that from the Upside Down. I mean, that show terrified me. I watched a few episodes, closed my eyes, and cried myself to sleep that night. But the few clips I saw of him after I watched this movie was pretty good, pretty good. He was a great movie. Great. He's a good actor. He's a great actor. I want to see him in more things. And Olivia Dijon as Priscilla Presley. She really sold that pain that was starting to creep up in their relationship over the years. And she did a really good job and really sold that scenes really well. And just that whole relationship and how toxic it kind of became for the king. But yes, audience, on a biopic level, this is probably one of the best biopics I've ever seen. Just train pace, living through this whole guy's life. You just at the end, you're like, there's no time to breathe. You're just living through Elvis Presley, every pill he popped, every lady he smooched. It was incredible. Also, the attention to detail of the sets and atmosphere and all the little editing choices they put in. It made you feel like you're going through this whole ordeal. And the attention to detail on the wardrobe and the sets are just impeccable and just captured the atmosphere of the times and also gave it a grandiose, like, pop he'll do it. And you can't forget the show-stopping performances by both Austin Butler and Tom Hanks, even though I still hate Tom Parker. They just captured those characters and people so very well, with actual three-dimensional shapes to them, you know. They're three-dimensional, not 2D characters or cartoonish sleaze bags. They're actual people-like characters, which surprised me coming from the Tom Hanks performance, but... Yeah, and Elvis fans... Yes, yeah. All of you Elvis fans, especially you, Sullivan. This movie will make you cry at the end. It's just a touching homage to the king.
Oh, don't make me cry now.
There's a touching homage, but it's just really well, real.
Zay.
It's just really real. It's just really well realized, and it really knows how to celebrate the legacy, the come up, and the legacy of such an incredible figure in music history. And that's why I have to give Buzz Lerman's Elvis an 8.3 out of 10. I know I'm not just another reviewer, or I'm just another Elvis impersonator, or whatever you want to call me, but I believe this is what the score should be, because it's just one of the best biopics I've ever seen, and it's just one of the most fast-paced and energetic movies I've seen all year, so yeah, that's my little movie book report for you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Please hold your applause. Yeah. Remember the name, Melvis Wesley. Melvis Wesley. This has been Melvis Wesley, and Melvis has left the building. That's how you do a movie review.
Well, wasn't that something, folks? I hope you all have a good night.
Anyway, I know what you're looking for.
You do?
Yeah. Isn't it obvious? And I know of a magical version.
Really? How do you know about that?
I saw on Reddit, so you know it's true.
Oh yeah.
Big Brother 4.
Well, you better get going.
Only if you had a bite to ride there.
I told you for the millionth gazillion time, it was stolen from a North Sky.
Get out of here, you have a train to catch.
See ya, Timmy.